Good Tuesday, everybody. Jewel here with J749 Weather Channel. Here we have a look at the future radar. Let's turn it on. Down in Florida this morning, you see where these heavier showers are for the morning hours. This is what's going to be happening. Now, they're going to progress along, and everyone in eastern North Carolina. This includes Washington, Edenton, Plymouth, Creswell, you name it. All the way up and down, moving up into Virginia, all the way up. You'll see as they progress along. This afternoon, after lunchtime, is when we should get ours. And the biggest threat for eastern North Carolina is the winds, the downdraft winds. Now, these downdraft winds can cause just as much problem as a tornado. They just don't last long, and they don't travel far, but our winds could be up to 60 miles per hour this afternoon. Also, we do have a chance of some nickel-sized hail, and the rain is looking like anywhere from a half an inch to an inch. And for eastern North Carolina, also for maybe Norfolk, Virginia Beach, this area should be having these heavier storms come in somewhere between 2 p.m. and 8 p.m. this evening. Checking out all the hurricane names and tropical storm names again for the 2021 season. Next one coming up, as you can see, is Danny, after that Elsa and Fred, and so on. Let's hope we don't get too far up in this. Today is Tuesday, the 22nd of June, 2021. Thank you so much, each and every one of you, for clicking play and checking out all of the weather with me today. And I want to say thank you to Pamela Kelly. She sent me a Get Well e-card yesterday. Thank you so much, Pamela, and thank all of you for your prayers. I am feeling a little better now. Thank you so much for doing that for me and standing by me. Now, as we check out the tropical weather right quick, here is the five-day outlook from the National Hurricane Center down in Miami, Florida. Now, we see this. This was 20 yesterday. It's 30 today. It switched over to a 30% chance late yesterday afternoon. It's just a tropical wave right now, though. It's about 650 miles east, southeast of the Windward Islands, and it is producing disorganized showers, and a few thunderstorms are popping up in it. Now, there is a little bit of a chance of development of this area possible during the next couple of days, but it does look like the upper level winds will become less conducive for further organization by Thursday. I'm watching it. I'm going to show you some things. The system is expected to move westward to west-northwestward around 15 to 20 miles per hour, and the chance is 30% for 2 days and 5 days. Now, I've checked all the models out. I know a lot of you use a GFS model, and yesterday over here in the Gulf, we had a system. At one point, it looked like it popped up. Maybe it would turn into a hurricane. I'm not going to elaborate on that. I don't think it'll happen right now. It could happen in the future, though. We're going to watch this area. Now, I think this one will disintegrate, and I'm going to show all the island areas, including Puerto Rico, how much wind you should get out of this system. You are going to get rain, so go ahead and prepare for that. It's not going to be a great big washout, but you're going to get rain. But by Friday, do not be surprised if another area right down here does not pop up. And it looks like it may develop, it may not. I'll put it this way. It's going to fight those trade winds, and I mean the shear wind, and it's going to fight the dust. I don't know if it will materialize or not. We'll just keep our eyes on it and see what happens. As we come over to the European model, here's the little system right in here. And I've got this set already for Thursday at 3 a.m. in the morning. You can see it doesn't look like a whole lot, but the rain is coming. The rain is coming. So we'll just turn this on. And this is the European model. You can see the rain is coming with this. And it's going to bounce up probably here in a moment because this little high is going to see how it's bouncing it up a little bit. This is just rain coming in with it, so you can expect some rain. We will go over to the wind. Now, this is just sustained winds. They're not bad at all. Wind gust. We'll go to wind gust if I click on over here right quick. Now, this is around 8 a.m. on Thursday morning. You can see we do have some wind gusts, not too bad popping up. Let's see what we got. 27 miles per hour. That's not bad at all. So that's looking pretty good. We'll let this run a little bit here and move on through. You can see a little bit of these wind gusts are going to be coming up just around Puerto Rico, but moving down for the most part. We're up to lunchtime Thursday now. As you can see, it's still trying to do something, but the winds are going to get to it. And by Thursday evening, afternoon, say around 4 p.m., it just kind of hangs around in these areas here with just a little bit of gusty wind for the island areas right in this area here as it moves on through. So let's just stop this and let me do it manually. Let's hop up to around 1 a.m. Friday morning. Can see a little bit of winds coming in here over in the Bahama chain. You guys are going to be getting some winds, looks like some gusty winds, maybe if my internet will work, of around 24 miles per hour. So that's nothing that you can't handle either. These are the wind gusts. Now, what I want you to notice, you see over here coming off the coast of Africa once again. Right in here, we do have this system. It's a wave, it's a tropical wave, but I'm going to move up to around 4 p.m. It pressure's 29.79. It does try to get a little bit of vorticity to it, just a tad, and right in the middle there, we'll see those winds are up to 38 mile per hour in gusts. So we're going to watch the little system right here that's showing up now. I think it will dissipate. We got another one coming off that we really got to keep our eyes on. And always at this point, keep your eyes on the Gulf. As we take a look at the NDFD map, you can see I've got it set at the very beginning here. Tuesday, 12Z run. Heavy rain all the way from portions of Pennsylvania, moving right on down through West Virginia, parts of Northern Virginia, Western Virginia. Looking like it's going to be in the western sections of North Carolina, moving right on down into the panhandle of Florida, and it is going to continue. Now, everybody in Florida, especially right down in these areas here where you see these lines where the darker green is, you be on the outlook because you could have some severe storms to hatch up. For Wednesday, looking like tomorrow won't be such a severe weather day so far as thunderstorm activity goes, but it's going to ramp back up. You can see it. 6 a.m. and 6Z run in the morning. Things are looking light, not too bad. 12Z run down around southern Georgia and Florida. You got the greatest chance. By Thursday, though, it doesn't look too bad right now, but it is going to ramp up, especially down around portions of Upper Michigan, portions of Iowa and Wisconsin, and the poor folks down in the areas of Chicago have really been hit bad with tornadoes over the last few hours. And those folks need our prayers. Many people have lost their homes completely. People were in their homes when they were destroyed by tornadoes and severe storms. Some people are in the hospital, and some people have even died. So let's keep all of these people in our thoughts and prayers. Before I continue with the severe weather for today, there is still a critical fire risk for the Great Basin and Southwest areas. Your everything you got, all your conditions are just ripe, and a fire could pop up, and we don't need that right now. So keep that in mind if you're in those areas. Now, the severe thunderstorms, they're looking very possible across parts of Nebraska, Iowa, including a threat for large hail, damaging winds, and isolated strong to severe storms. They're possible also across parts of the Mid-Atlantic, as I've showed you, the southeast, the northeast sections of New Mexico, and the interior portions of the Pacific Northwest. Now, when it, no chance of tornadoes that it's looking like right now, but anything could happen. You need to be aware and stay up on what your surrounding skies are looking like as the day goes on. Biggest chance of wind up in these areas, you can hit 60 to 70 mile per hour winds. All of the East Coast here, we could hit 60 mile per hour winds. And so far as the hail, I mentioned earlier, eastern North Carolina, maybe Norfolk, Virginia, in these areas here, we could have some hail mixed in. It's not showing it here, but it's only nickel-size hail. Now, where you see the greatest amount of quarter-size or larger hail is going to be in Nebraska and Iowa with these storms. That's what could occur today. So please, please, stay safe, everybody. Tomorrow should be a lesser day for severe weather, but then by Thursday, looks like some places are going to crank right back up. Thanks so much for watching, my friends, my wonderful subs and new friends and subs that are coming on board. If you haven't subscribed, remember to do so. I'd appreciate it so very much, especially during this time of the year. Everybody needs to be aware of what's going on. Just click that little J7409 weather insignia in the bottom right-hand corner, then click that bell and check off all, and that will ensure that you get all my latest weather videos as they come out. I'd appreciate that a lot. Now, I'm going to keep up on tropical weather. Everybody hang tight. It is this time of the year. I'll keep my eyes on all of these things as they pop up. Stay safe and have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. Thanks for everything you guys do for me. Peace, love, and kindness to all.